flache Karte von der Weltkugel runter.
Perhaps the most significant experiments were those carried out on a canal known as the Old Bedford Level. Located in Cambridgeshire, England, the canal is perfectly straight over an uninterrupted 6-mile stretch. A boat carrying a flag rowed from one bridge to another 6 miles away. An observer with a telescope placed 8 inches above the surface of the water found that the flag and the boat were distinctly visible throughout the entire distance. If the Earth is a sphere with a circumference of 25,000 miles, then over a distance of 6 miles, the second bridge should mathematically be 16 feet below the observer's eye line. But in spite of the mathematical evidence, any further attempts to restore belief in the flat Earth seem doomed by one of the supposed great moments in modern scientific achievement.
Tja, das ist das Geheimnis. Auf einer flachen Karte stimmen oben und unten die Verhältnisse nicht. Grönland ist auf der flachen Karte viel größer. Und nur in der Mitte, da wo die Welt am dicksten ist, am Äquator, da wo Afrika ist, da stimmen die flache Karte und der Globus in etwa überein. Und so ist das einzig richtige Bild der Kugel Erde die Abbildung auf dem Globus. So ist das einzig richtige Bild der Kugel Erde die Abbildung auf dem Globus.
One place you have the sun directly overhead, and at another place at the same time, 530 miles away, let us suppose that it does make an angle of 7.2 degrees to the vertical, then we have a right angle triangle, which it can be easily shown that the sun is a sum of 4,000 miles up in the sky. These superficial even considerations show that it's impossible, the whole thing. It's a story, a fairy story made up and mindlessly repeated in textbooks.
Earth is infinite and flat. It goes on and on forever, infinite and flat. The gravitational force doesn't depend on how high you are. Same gravitational force here as here.